In this session, I am going to explain you how to solve a problem by writing a Java program. Okay? Look at here the problem for whom we are going to write a Java program. In this problem, it is mentioned the class having two data members, that is the name of employee and the basic pay. And what we have to calculate here? We have to calculate the gross pay from the allowances and deduction. That also we have to calculate. That is not given, that from the basic pay we have to calculate. And it is saying you to use certain meaningful variables. Okay, so what is the calculation it has to do for the allowances and deduction? How to calculate the DRN's allowances, 25% of basic pay, HRA, provident fund, net pay and gross pay also we have to calculate based on all this formula. Okay. Now, I always telling you that when you start writing a program, first you should understand the question. You read the question, you find out what are the input data for the program, what are the calculation you are going to do, what are the output you have to find out after the calculation. These three things first you find out. Okay. After that, you should give a proper name to the variable. Okay, means meaningful name to the variable. Here, how to give the name to the variable I have mentioned here. Okay, first I identify what are the input, that is the name of the employee. I have given the variable name as EMP name. I cannot use the long name, name of employee, it is very long and you cannot, it is not allowed to give a space between the word. So I make it short and make it as a EMP name. Same way basic pay, another data, that is input data. I have given it as a name as a basic. What the calculation I have to do? The DRN's allowances we have to calculate. The formula it is given, 25% of basic pay. So how to calculate the DA? Basic into 25/100. So like same way we have to calculate the house rent allowances. The name I have mentioned it as a HRA, provident fund that is named as a PF, net pay we have mentioned it as a net pay. Okay, so how to calculate the net pay? After calculating DA, HRA, we have to add these three things, basic, DA and HRA. Okay, and after that gross pay we have to calculate. So I naming it as a gross. So how to find out the gross pay? Net pay already we calculate, PF already we have calculate, so net pay minus provident fund. Okay, now the output what you have to show it here, whatever the calculation we had done, that everything we have to show. So that will be DA, HRA, provident fund, net pay and the gross pay. Okay. Here you see I have written an algorithm for the Java program. Always try to write the algorithm before start writing the actual Java program in the computer. That help you the error free program. Okay, and you can able to understand the logic and steps also. Here you see the algorithm. First what I did, defining the class, then I opening curly braces, then define the main method, then again define the curly braces, then define the variable, that is your input data, that is EMP name and the basic, and it is the static initialization with a certain value. Then I calculate what is the calculation, that is the DA, HRA, PF, net pay, gross. Okay, these are the shortcut name of the data. Okay, and after calculation everything, then we have to display the result. Then we ended the curly braces of the main method. Then we end the class by the close end curly braces of the class. Okay. In my next slide, I have shown you the step-by-step procedures how to write the Java program. Okay, but before going to that slide, I am going to tell you certain things which you have to remember, and it is important also. When you start writing the Java program, you try to give comments in each and every part to explain the steps. Second thing, the keyword always be you have to write in the lowercase character. Okay, and the variable name, it is depend upon you whether it you can write it in the uppercase and or can also be lowercase. But if you maintain the order, if you have written in the uppercase in each and every part, you have to write in the uppercase. If you written you have written in the lowercase, then each and every part you have to mention in the lowercase. Otherwise, the compiler will show you the error. Next thing, the where you have to put the semicolon. Where the line is ended, there you have to put the semicolon. And where the continuation is going on, there you cannot give the semicolon. Just like in after main method, you cannot put the semicolon. After define the class, you cannot put the semicolon. Why I am telling you all those things? Because the student making mistake here. Most of the student giving the semicolon after the class or after the main function. So the compiler show you the error. And it is very difficult to find out the error also. Okay. So when the line will be ended, there you have to put the semicolon. Now after that, what you will do? You will see such a symbol on the screen. So these blue Java icons you can see on the desktop. Then you double click there, your blue Java editor screen will be open up. Where you open your project which is already you have created, and you start creating adding the Java program there. So you have to, after opening your project, you click on the new class, and that will help you to write a Java program. So you can clear from the next slide where I have explained through the step by step procedure. So we see the icon, that is blue Java icon on the screen. We double click here. Okay, when we double click, it will open a screen for us. Already we have created a project, so we will add the Java program here. Whatever the new program will write, it will be added to this project. Okay, so first I have to open the new class, and the new class, it asks me to write the name of the class. So I have mentioned that is the employee. Okay, so here I am giving the name of the class as a, already the name of employee class program is present, so class is present, so I am writing some new name, employee1. Okay, employee1, then I give okay. So such type of screen it will be opened. So I have to right click here, open the editor, and then a sample program already given for me. So I just select the whole program, and then I by pressing Ctrl and A, then I press the delete key, it will delete it. Okay, then I start writing the program, like public. First I mention the comment. This comment I have to mention, this program I am writing for the program. I am writing for calculating gross pay. Okay, after that I have to write the public class employee1, whichever the class I have given. Then I have to give the curly braces. Okay, so I already have written a program. Just look at here, the already I have written the program, that is the employee program. I open this program, just look at here, that is the, this is the program used for calculating the gross salary of an employee, public class employee, public static void main string args. Then the curly braces, define the variable string employee name. Employee name, you just see here the string, the string whatever it is there, you till now you have not known about this string type. Any data value which will be more than one character, that variable data type will be string. That in the later chapter you will learn. Okay, just for the time being you have to learn which variable value will be more than one character, string of character, that data type you have to mention in the string. And when you storing the value, it should be in the double quotes. Okay, the double quotes present, you have to mention in the double quotes. Okay, ended with the semicolon. Here you see in the after main function I have not given any semicolon, and after class also I have not mentioned any semicolon. Basic is my integer type. Okay, so I have taken as a 30,000 as a basic.
but it will be going to calculated, that is calculating the DA, HRA, PF, net pay and gross. So here the it is in the decimal value, so it will be going to calculate it as a decimal value. So that's why I have given it as a double, the data type as a double. So double DA, double HRA, double PF, double net pay, double gross pay. Okay, how to calculate? The basic into 25 by 100, HRA is equal to basic into 15 by 100. In the question it is mentioned, this is the formula how to calculate the DA, HRA, PF, net pay. And net pay will be the basic plus DA plus HRA, and the gross pay will be net pay minus provident fund. Then I have to display the result. I prepared a output in such a way that will be look nice and one can understand from this output. First I given the heading as employee salary. So system.outprintln, and whatever the message I have to put in within the double quotes. Then name of the employee within double quotes, and the variable name plus without double quote you have to write. The variable name you should not use the double quotes. Same way, the basic of the employee within double quote, this is the message, but the value, when the value will be printed, there you have to mention the variable name, that should not be in the double quotes. Like such a way, I have printed all the output. After that, I have to close it. First, I have to compile it. Compile, show me no syntax error. Then I have to close. Okay. After that, I have to go to the void main string args. When I am showing, this screen will be coming up. Then I give OK and it will show me the output. Here you see employee salary details. Name of the employee is the Rahul. Basic of the employee is the 30,000. Variance allowances, it is calculated. As all total it is calculated, gross pay of the employee will be this much after deducting the provident fund. Okay. This is all about the program to find out the salary of an employee. Thank you.